How you doing out there, folks? Yes, it's me, Frankie the Unknown Songwriter. Yeah, I make these videos from time to time, and about different things. This time I decided, since I keep saying I'm the Unknown Songwriter, I can show you why. I'm going to prove it to you. Because I got a letter here from Bobby Helms from over 40 years ago. I sent him two of my songs, for evaluation. He was a singer at that time, but he also had a songwriter service, so I figured, why not? It was a free evaluation, so I sent two songs. Now, maybe you don't know about Bobby Helms. The biggest song he had was Jingle Bell Rock. It's 1957, so that's over 60 years ago. So I figured, well, let me do it. Now, he sent me a two-page type letter. Now, he typed it. I know he typed it. He could have somebody do it, but it doesn't have, on page two, it doesn't have the initials. When someone types a letter for somebody, they usually put their initials and the person's initials they typed it for whoever they sent it to. So I noticed it doesn't have it on this letter. It's got the date. I know that's all important. I don't know how important this letter is. Somebody collecting memorabilia might be interested in this letter. If you are, just contact me. I had mentioned it before, but I'm going to read it this time. I'm going to show it to you. Okay, here's two pages. This is page one. All typed nice and a nice job of typing. See it? I don't know if you can really see it here at that distance. You might be able to. I don't know. Blow it up. Okay, that's page one. Let me get page two here. Page two. Now, the difference with page two is, of course, the signature's at the bottom. So now I'm going to show you the signature. See it? He typed it. He left room to, to sign it. Bobby Helms. October 8th, 1980. You see how that looks? Now I know that that's a Senex signature, definitely. As I compared it, what other some things that he signed, I looked it up online, but I don't know if this would be worth, since it is over 60 years ago. Well, no, well, 60 years ago when he was singing the songs, but this is over 40 years ago when he signed this. Yeah, it's in good shape. It's like on parchment paper. I'm going to try to read it. Okay, let's see. Part two, part one. Now, this is the evaluation of two songs that I sent him. I sent it on cassette. Audio cassette, demos, so they could listen to it. I thought he would really like them, but not according to this evaluation, which is what I want. I don't want somebody to say, sugarcoat something and say it's good in order to make me subscribe to the service or pay money for them to do, other work. And I could tell it wasn't that. Now, he had singers and songwriters, do the evaluation, and one of them was Johnny Mathis. I know that because I looked it up. So he had people that was in the business doing this, the reviewers, as you might call them. Okay, it says Bobby Helms, Songwriting Service, Nashville, Tennessee. In the valuation, here's the two songs. There's a heaven in the sky above, and the world's at your feet. Normally, we would render separate papers on the songs you have submitted. However, the opinion of the reviewers is the same. I knew right away when I heard this, it wasn't going to be good. Well, it's what I want. I want the truth. I didn't want anything, like I said, sugar-coated, Wouldn't do me any good. I still didn't change anything since then, though. No matter what he said, I still stuck with the same songs. See, different music, though, and different singers, I know can make a difference. He doesn't mention that. That if he sung one of my songs, don't you think, with his reputation and all, that it might have had a better chance? It maybe not be a big hit, but still be pretty good. Okay, these songs have been reviewed by our staff for the basic points of the craft. story, composition, construction, and thought. It is the unanimous decision of the reviewers is that these songs are not commercial songs and are not competitive in today's market. Now, I sent him two songs. I would have liked him to do each song, but he treated it as one, you know, in a sense. So I said, it's okay, I'm not paying him for this evaluation. Okay. Let's see, where was I here now? The poorly constructed with trite words and lines using old subject matter that has been written many times before and better. So I took something from before and I didn't even do it good by doing that. I really didn't do that. The songs are contrived without much thought. The type of song commonly heard that appears to be continuous thought at the time it was written or put down, and certainly doesn't seem to be worked or rewritten. Well, I didn't take that much time on the songs. I took the titles and then I worked on them. I didn't do it like in 2 minutes, but you know, I wrote it a little bit and then I wrote it again another time and went back to it. Because these titles, and plus I discussed it with my wife, and I had told her when we first started going together, she knew I was writing songs. And she even told me, Frankie, she always called me Frankie, you know, you never know, you keep writing them, you never know, you might get somebody to sing one of them, and it could be hit. She encouraged me, and she said, but right now, you're unknown, and that's why she's the one that called me that. Said, you're an unknown songwriter, because I'm the only one that know about you. So I said, okay, I agree with her. So, you know, that was the way it's been. And I like my anonymity, so I didn't care about it. Okay, so let's get back to where I was here. Even if the various subject matter were acceptable, at least one of the thoughts should have consistency. He's saying both of the songs. You know, completely, the one's about heaven and one's about something else. So he still says the same thing about both of them. I would have liked the individual evaluation, but I guess since I sent two songs, and he's given me a pretty good evaluation, though. The title themes are worn in use. But if these ideas are necessary, then the line should be more original. Lines like how tough life is, problems getting you down, color of your face, all belong to the human race, stars, sun and moon, moon and sun, and wind and rain, plus most of the other lines are terms used by inexperienced writers all the time. They lack imagination, work, and creativity. So those lines, I didn't hear those lines before. I mean, anything about wind and rain, you hear that in a lot of songs. I understand that. But the lines that I liked on that one song was, no matter what color your face, we all belong to the human race. I thought that was a good line. Especially now, if you apply, maybe then, but now I know. With all the things going on, that's not a bad line. That's original. I didn't get that from nobody. But it was what I thought at the time. As writers, we usually get an idea, but fall to the follow-through or simply don't know how. You probably thought you had a great song ideas with your titles, but then the task of writing what you thought, felt, came, it wasn't there, so the common trite words and lines begins to flow. It came together and you did it. Therefore, it must be good, not true. Well, I did do it and I did have demos. I mean, done. It wasn't like, and plus those companies that I had the work done, you know, the demos, they might change it to make it more commercial. You know, but knowing that they're going to take anything anybody sends because they didn't really care. He'll just put the music and make you the demos. The ego and satisfaction of creation and completion often are the obstacles to creativity, commercial writing. The melody is the better part of your songs. Yeah, the demos. Because I didn't do the music. Maybe he thought I did the music. Maybe he thought I'm singing it. Because I had George Liberace in California do the work. You know, the demos and all, and the lead sheets and all. I know they did it good. See, he even admitted that. He admitted that that part was good. Okay, now the opinion part. That was evaluation. You have writing potential. Your music is better than your lyrics. Just what I tell you? The music was done by George Liberace. They're a good company. Of all the companies out there. You should continue to write. Seek subject matter from outside your emotion and take it by theme to line after line to create the whole. So, you know, he's right. I did take titles that I liked, you know, subject matter. Because a lot of these titles I did do was, they were inspired by my wife, a lot of it. Songs are stories, theme, plot, and climax. Good songs are told is the title, in the title. If you don't tell your story in the first verse, you have no song. The best song is a story told in a minimum of lines. The story matter is limited. Therefore, the trick is to take old matter and tell it in a new fresh way. It is not different and better. It's not. So, I don't know. I didn't get this exactly. You know what he said? There's still more. This was a pretty long evaluation. See, it's not that bad. Okay, let's see now. It says part two. Work your songs. Write and rewrite until you have achieved originality. You will know when it is right. I would not recommend that you spend time or money on these songs. And so do not have them demoed. Now, I already sent him a demo. I suggest that you discard them altogether and start over with a new song. Frank, it is not easy to sell someone his work is bad, especially in an area as personal as songwriting. But if you want to be a commercial earning writer, you must learn first to take constructive criticism. He doesn't know if I'm going to take constructive criticism. He thinks I'm going to be upset. I wasn't. I was so glad that he told me, you know, what he really thought. You know, it was an honest opinion, and I really liked it. I took it as, you know, as you would take it, you know. I wasn't upset because, first of all, I wasn't trying to write songs to become rich or famous. So that's why it didn't matter. He thought that I'm trying to make a career out of that and, you know, not do any other work. I hope you will continue to write, but treat it as a business. Learn your craft. Above all, practice. Practice is the difference between success and failure. Everything we write is not a jewel. Some songs we write are just an excessive exercise towards the gem that awaits all of us. The competition is stiff, and even with good songs, it's hard. The more reason why you have to write better. One last suggestion. If you have a lot of songs like the two you have submitted, I suggest that you discard all of them. At least put them aside and not try to sell them or spend money on them. If you are not sure, I will review all of them for one fee. and advise you rather than spending $50 on each one. See, he mentions that. You know, that he didn't charge me for all this. But if I had other songs, but then he's going to charge me a fee after that. Your direction and ability is obvious, and I feel certain that all of your songs are the same. Therefore, I would not want you to waste money on further evaluation. He's telling me he doesn't want to charge me for evaluation, you know, for the songs if they're not, if they're like the ones I sent him, but yeah, I still would have done it. There's a tip now at the end. He's giving me a tip. Never submit a voice and guitar tape to publishers. It is all right to this office, but when you are ready with that, no, that's number one. Song, it must be a professional demonstration recording. By the way, the singer is good on your tape. Thank you. Very truly yours, Bobby Helms. October 8th, 1980. That's a good evaluation. I mean, I went by it. I mean, I still have the same songs. I didn't change them. I just felt that what I said in the songs, he didn't realize that. Like the one with There's a Heaven in the Sky Above. Anybody that believes in the Bible and everything, they believe that there's a heaven in the sky above. They don't believe that it's down below. So I figured, well, we can encourage people to believe in God. Because like one of the lines in that song was, he didn't mention that. They say that the earth is round, but it doesn't mean to this earth you are bound. It's got a lot of hidden meaning in these songs, but I don't think he got it. He just looked at maybe the words and the construction and all. But there was a good line right there. You know, that it means that we're not bound to this earth. Everybody knows that we're just passing through. We have a beginning, middle, and end of our life, and that's just an end. So that was when, and then the other song, The World's at Your Feet, that's, I was giving people hope, opportunity. You know that your problems are getting you down. Now's the time to stop messing around. Somebody might read that and say, you know what? Let me keep trying, you know. I might just still get a job or something. And that was the one that had the line, no matter what color your face, we all belong to the human race. So I just want to go over that. And I just want to say that proves that I was writing songs over 40 years ago, doesn't it? With a two-page letter like that from Bobby Helms. You know, pretty well-known singer and all. And I just thought I would mention that now because it's come up about, you know, songwriter. You know, that what they think. This, you know, with all this fake news and all, you think that I'm a fake? No. I wrote plenty of songs. But according to what he said, they were not that well done. I don't look at it that way. Anybody that took one of my songs could change the wording a little. And maybe it's the type of song they're looking for, it's different or something. And if it was a good singer, it could be a hit. You know, only a few songs become hits, I know that. You know, there's such a thing as one-hit wonders. There's not too many of them. There's a lot of singers and groups, they had hits. That's all they ever had was the one-hit wonder. That's it. There was an example of this, I know there was a song, Left My Heart in San Francisco. It was 25 years on the shelf. Nobody wanted it. Oh, it's the worst song ever written. Who wants to hear a song about San Francisco when you live somewhere else? It would only appeal to people in San Francisco, but not necessarily. Tony Bennett got a hold of it, and he liked it. And you know what happened. It's one of his biggest hits, I Left My Heart in San Francisco. So you never know. So I still have hope that someday one of my songs might have a chance, you know, to get to a good singer. It could be any singer that it might help a singer with one of these songs. They might help boost their career. You never know. It might jumpstart their career. So I could collaborate with somebody at some point in time. So I don't give up on it completely. I hope you enjoyed this presentation. You know, it might help somebody out there that's writing songs, they hear what he said about mine, and it might give them ideas, you know, how to do better. I don't know about this now. I had something here. I was going to try to do a song by Bobby Helms. I don't know if it's still here. Okay. Still, I didn't lose it here on my recording. Okay, I'm going to do the Jingle Bell Rock. Since it's around Christmas time, and I'm going to mime it. And this is the song. Now, listen to the words, though. It's not, I don't think it's that great. I mean, you know, because it became a big hit, though. He had other songs that weren't that big of a hit. So this is Jingle Bell Rock by Bobby Helms, 1957. I'm going to make an attempt to do it, and that'll be the end of the video. Thanks for viewing my videos. I appreciate it.
Shows of fun. Now the jingle hop has begun. Jingle bell, jingle bell, jingle bell rock. Jingle bells chime and jingle bell time. Dancing and prancing in Jingle Bell Square. In the frosty air. What a bright time. It's the right time to rock the night away. One horse sleigh. Giddy up, jingle horse, pick up your feet. Jingle around the clock. Mix and a mingle in the jingling feet. That's the Jingle Bell Rock.
Jingle bell, jingle bell, jingle bell rock. Jingle bell chime and jingle bell time. Dancing and prancing in Jingle Bell Square.
Gliding in the one horse sleigh.